So it has been a while since I talked about the Workflow app. This is an app that Apple purchased a year or so ago, and they've improved it greatly since. And you can do all sorts of things with it in iOS. It's kind of like Automator for your iPhone or iPad. And some of the recent additions to it have made it so powerful. So let's just build an example here. I'm going to go into Workflow here, and I can see all of my workflows that I've built so far. But I'm going to tap the Create Workflow to make a new one. Now notice I've got three different types of workflows. One is the normal workflow, which is kind of like just an application I can run. Another is something that's added to the notification screen, the today part of it. And another is a share action. But I'm just going to stick with the normal workflow right now. So I've got that selected already. I'm going to swipe to the right to reveal all the actions. And at the top it shows suggested there. I'm going to go back so I can see all of them. I can see all of these different types of workflow actions that I could add in. But I'm going to search for them. So as an example, let's create one that is going to allow me to quickly send an email. Let's say in this scenario I need to occasionally send an email reminder to a colleague to remind them to do something. And I don't want to have to go and compose the entire message from scratch each time. So I can have Workflow do it for me. I'm going to search here at the top for mail to see what's available. And I can see there's one for send mail. I can tap it and I can read the description. So it's going to send an email, or at least get one ready to send. I can review it first. Any text that I pass into it is going to be in the body of it. So let's first use this here. I'm going to select it and drag to the right. That's how you do it to add it to the workflow list. So here I can see that I can set some things up. Like for instance, I can do the to. So I'm going to do to test add example .com. I could set CC, BCC, I could set subject, reminder. And so far so good. But I want the message to actually say something. So how do I do that? Well, I'm going to have to pass some text into it. So let me go back over to the list here and let me search for text. And right at the top there's one called text, and I look at that and it says passes the specified text to the next action. It's exactly what I want. I'm going to bring that over and put that on top. Now I can type this. This is your reminder. Great. So now I've got, this is your reminder. It gets passed into a send email action that's going to have the to field pre-filled in, subject pre-filled in, ready to go. So now I'll hit done. And it's called Untitled Workflow. So let's go back in there and hit settings and then rename it. Reminder email. Done. Great. So now done again. And let's test this out. I'm going to hit the play button at the top to see what happens. Hit play. And you can see right there, it composes the email. There's the text inside it. It's to the right person. All I need to do is hit send to actually send this. Really easy to do. Now, I'll hit cancel in this case. And I'm going to go back into settings. Let's first try add it to the home screen. Now I can pick something for this. So let's pick a glyph that's maybe some sort of email kind of thing. There we go. And I can pick a color, and I can go to done, and it's going to actually do this little thing here. It'll walk me through adding it. So it basically launches it in Safari here. I have to hit the share button and I hit add to home screen, and I get a chance to name it if I want, but I'll leave it as that name. I'll hit add. Now you can see reminder email is actually there as something on the home screen. If I tap it, it will run that script in Workflow, and there's my reminder, and I can hit send and send it off. Really convenient. So two steps basically. I can send this reminder email to a colleague. So what if I were to switch and make this a today widget instead? Now I hit done, and now when I swipe from my home screen over to reveal the today screen on the left, I could see I've got a workflow widget there, and you can hit edit at the bottom of the screen to edit the order in which things appear or whether or not workflow appears at all. But you can see workflow has got three different workflows in there that all have been set to be on the today screen, and I could tap the one for reminder email and it will bring it up there as well. So it's just another way to do it without maybe cluttering your home screen with a whole bunch of icons. This is just one of the many, many cool things you can do now in workflow. There's so many different things. I encourage you to explore it. And if you like this tutorial and you want me to do more tutorials on using workflow, let me know here in the comments.